Hello everybody, Brandon McDonald here, and today we have a new Left Behind update, so I'm so excited to show you guys this, and this is about the casting of Buck. Kevin Sorbo will be playing Rayford Steele, and I can never pronounce this guy's name, but this guy I'm about to show you will be playing Buck Williams.
My name is Greg Perot. I play the character of Cameron Buck Williams.
So it's really fun being a part of this project because growing up, my father was a huge fan of all of the books. And funny enough, he always tried to get my sister and I to join in, but we were too afraid to read them because I grew up in a Christian household. We believe in Jesus. We believe in the rapture. And for whatever reason, my sister and I were not ready for that information at our age. But it is really cool, just full circle, how this comes around and I'm able to share this experience and for my dad as well. It's really fun. So I was really excited to see the arc of this character, specifically the rise of the Antichrist, where Buck, he comes to know Christ. I was excited to play this journey for him because I can relate. Although I grew up as a Christian and I've been a Christian my entire life, you know, there's years where you really search for truth and answers and meaning. You question, is it just how I was raised or do I actually believe this? And so I personally was able to relate to his character in the arc throughout the story. And I just think it's really cool. It's really cool to watch somebody ask questions and search for truth and discover faith. And I'm excited to share these scenes with you guys. So my relationship with Chloe, or Cameron's relationship with Chloe in the story, I think Chloe really was an anchor for Cameron. In the sense that he cares so much for this individual. He loves this person. And to watch her kind of have this transition, it sparks something inside you, the curiosity. I mean, he's constantly asking questions. And so to watch somebody that you love encounter a relationship with Christ and to see the truth in that, because he's always searching for the truth, it played a huge factor in his own walk in discovering God. So when I found out Kevin Sorbo was going to be directing, I was very excited, not only because is he a phenomenal actor, I also know he's a man of God, and I was just really excited to be a part of this project with him. Although it is early on set right now, I'm really stoked to get in there and just really dive into the character with him, not only just from a technique standpoint of view, but just the overall journey working with Kevin. I'm really excited. So I just want to say that being a part of this project, it means everything, because being a believer, so many times as an actor in Hollywood, we're challenged with our morals and we don't really get the chance to express within our storytelling our morals and our beliefs and our relationship with God. And so being a part of this project really means a lot to me, that I can share my values and I can share my morals and hopefully I can reach people, and through my story and Cameron's story, we can tell the story of Christ to a lot of people watching this. So that's kind of what I hope for the audience, and I think they're gonna challenge their thoughts when they watch this film. I think it's gonna really dig deep and help people search in their journey for discovering God.
So yeah, literally guys, I'm so excited for this movie. Let me know what you guys think down below. Are you hyped for this? What do you think? So I'm a big fan. I started reading back in 2010 the books, and they fascinated me, the story did. So I started watching the movies, they were good. Then I watched the movies and they didn't follow the books. So now they're going back to follow the books, they're saying. But if you know, like, from one of yesterday's videos, literally they talked about not having it take place like it's in the 90s, but more modernized. So yes, things are going to change in the movie to make it more modern, because the series was based back in the 90s, so it makes sense. Especially if you're going to be telling about the future in a movie, you know, you have to make it click with the modern times instead of going back in time and claiming it's for the future. So I kind of get that. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. Please subscribe for more Left Behind updates. I have a new Percy Jackson update coming soon, so stay tuned for that, and I'll keep you up to date. They release a thing every night, so every day we should get a new piece of footage or photos from the set of Left Behind Rise of the Antichrist with Kevin Sorbo. So excited, guys. And this is Brandon McDonald signing out. I'll see you out there, movie lovers. This is Brandon McDonald signing out.